Well, hallelujah and blessings, friends. Welcome back to Haya Kadosh Ministries, where holiness is a way of life, and Jesus is truly King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And together God's people say, praise the Lamb, hallelujah. Well, friends, we are continuing our study in the book of Galatians, and today we're going to start getting into some of the meat, maybe the more difficult to understand things in this great book. So if you have your Bibles, turn to Galatians chapter 3, and let's begin in verse 1. O foolish Galatians! Now remember, we have ended chapter 2 with Paul specifying the difference between grace and the law. And he's still struggling with this issue. So he's setting forth to use some common sense factors of reasoning to try to get through to these young Christians. And maybe to try to get through to you and me as well. I know as I read this, this pricks my heart because it's so easy to fall into the works of the law. And so when I read this, I don't necessarily read, O foolish Galatians. I read, O foolish believers. More specifically, O foolish Pastor Don. Who has bewitched you? Who has hexed you? Who has tricked you and deceived you that you would not obey the truth? Now Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus also said, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. And so Jesus is who all of our doctrine should be based upon, and it is he who we follow. Not a man, not a religion, not a denomination, but Jesus, the promised one. And so he says, who has bewitched you that you are not obeying Jesus, before whose eyes he has been evidently set forth, crucified among you? And so Paul is saying, when I came to you and I told you about Jesus and you heard his message and it touched you and moved you and compelled you to repentance, if that is where you began, why are you so foolish in now trying a different way? Oh, friends, is this starting to get personal? It is for me. He says in verse 2, this only would I learn of you. This is what I've heard about you. This is what others are telling me about you. Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law? When the Spirit was poured upon you and you felt your burden fall away, when you experienced the love of God penetrate your heart for the first time in your life, when you felt the liberty and grace of the gospel, was this done because you were striving to be a good person? Was this done because you were striving to understand all doctrine? Or was this simply poured upon you, the Spirit of God, because you believed? And so what Paul is saying is, oh believer, when you knelt down, wherever you may have been in that moment, and you asked Jesus Christ to come into your life, you didn't understand the full impact of those words. You surely didn't understand all things about doctrine. You didn't know anything about baptism, repentance, sanctification, glorification, redemption. Your mind wasn't wrapped around like issues of paying tithes or speaking in tongues or where or when to go to church, predestination, the rapture. You didn't know anything about any of these doctrines. All you knew that you were a sinner and you needed salvation. And in that moment, God poured his grace out upon you. He planted his seed within you. And he sent down his Holy Spirit to lead, to guide, and to teach you. How can you be so foolish to be led away thinking that you can be justified by the works that you perform? That's what Paul is saying here. So again, he says in verse 3, are you so foolish, having begun in the Spirit? How are you now made perfect by the flesh? If your motives for the things that you do for God are simply to earn his favor, to earn his love, to get his attention, your motives are wrong, friends. Our good works are about bringing him honor. The attention is on him, not upon us. That's why so often when we do something good for someone and they pat us on the back, we reject that pat. because it's not about us. And if it were about us, without Christ, we would have never performed that good deed for them. And so maybe you're beginning to see how easily this can get twisted. He says in verse 4, "Have you suffered so many things in vain, if it yet be in vain?" In other words, the price that you paid to obtain your salvation, why would you leave such a sacrifice of good faith? It was Jesus who saved us, not our good works, not our good deeds, Jesus alone. And it was He in verse 5 that ministered to you the Spirit, who served us with the Spirit. Jesus said, "If I don't go, I can't send the Spirit back. But once I arrive at the throne room of the Father, I will send the Spirit back to you. And it is He who works miracles among you. It isn't anything that you're doing. It's God that performs such great deeds among us. And is He doing these things by the works of the law or by the hearing of faith?" Do you remember when Jesus healed people and He says it is because of your good deeds that you have obtained this healing? Of course not. Jesus always said it is because of your faith. And so we must remember how we came to God. It was in absolute surrender, shame, and guilt. And we were in great need, not deserving. And so He kind of starts to wrap this thought up and He says, "Even as Abraham believed God." Abraham didn't do anything. He hadn't had intercourse with Sarah yet based upon the fact of what God had promised him about his seed being blessed. He simply believed God, and because he believed God, he had intercourse with Sarah, and 13 years later, they had a son named Isaac who became the promised seed. And from Isaac came the lineage of Jesus, and from Jesus, praise God, comes the lineage of you and I, friends. We're not there by blood, we're there by faith. We weren't born Jews, we were made Jews because of our faith. That's what he's saying. And he says, "So as Abraham believed God, and it was accounted to him for righteousness, know ye therefore that they which are of faith, you and me, the same are the children of Abraham." So when God gave Abraham that promise thousands of years ago that in thy seed all nations of the earth will be blessed, he had you in mind, friend. He had me in mind. Hallelujah. Praise the Lamb. And the scripture that was written thousands of years ago, foreseeing that God would justify the heathen through faith. The heathen, the pagan, the Gentile, the non-believer, the sinner, will be justified through faith. When Paul wrote his letter to the Romans in chapter 3, verse 20, he says, "Therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in God's sight. But for by the law is the knowledge of sin." So the law serves a purpose. We understand that we are transgressors of the law because of the law. If there was no law, there would be no transgression. But because we know the law, now we see where we fall short. And that's why Jesus said, "Take my yoke upon you, it is easy. Take my burden upon you, it is light." Don't carry the yoke or the burden of the law, because if you don't keep every bit of it, you're guilty of all of it. If you fell in one point, you have offended in all points. And that's why, again, Paul says in the letter to Romans in chapter 7, verse 6, he says, "Should we serve in the newness of spirit?" Absolutely. We don't serve in the oldness of the letter, the oldness of the law. We serve in the newness of spirit. The grace that has been poured out upon us compels us to offer that grace unto others, to serve others, to love others, even the most despicable, even the most evil. That's why when you hear these so-called Christian people so often say that they'll kill ISIS, they'll defend their families, it doesn't stand with Scripture, because Jesus said, "Love your enemies, pray for your enemies, bless your enemies. Don't curse them and kill them." And so if you hear someone And I say this based upon the authority of Scripture. If you hear someone who says that they'll put a bullet between the eyes of ISIS or any other evil person that you can think, people who celebrated the death of bin Laden, of Jeffrey Dahmer, of Saddam Hussein, if they say such things, friends, they don't have the Spirit of God. Because the Bible tells us in Romans chapter 8, verse 9, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And you can be assured, Jesus took no pleasure in the death of Osama bin Laden, of Saddam Hussein, of Jeffrey Dahmer, or any other evil person as we would categorize them. This is a soul that has been lost to hell. And it breaks the heart of our Savior. And it should break our hearts as well, friends. And so Paul continues in Galatians 3, verse 8, the Scripture foreseeing that God would justify the heathen through faith. Now, does that mean all we have to do is believe? Well, of course not. James chapter 2, verse 19 says, the devils believe, and they believe to such a degree they tremble under that belief. But they'll not be saved. They'll not enter heaven. They'll not receive salvation and glory. Why? Because faith without works is dead. But we have to understand the priority. It isn't that we earn God's grace and favor by the works that we do, but because we have earned God's grace and favor, we are compelled to do such works. And it's so easy to get this confused, to get this twisted in the way we behave before God. And that's why Paul is spending so much time here with this young Christian fellowship, telling them, don't become foolish. Stand in the grace that you have received. Live in and by that grace. And don't get the message twisted. And verse 8 continues by saying that Abraham received this same message, this same gospel. Believe and perform. And if you do so, Abraham, all nations will be blessed because of it. And so what gratitude and thankfulness we owe to Father Abraham, because all of us are descendants of his based upon the belief that he had in God. And then we're going to end today with verse 9, which says, so then, because of everything that we've said this morning, because of everything that's been told to us here in this prior passage, because of this, so then, they that which be of faith are blessed with faithful Abraham. So the same way that God honored and blessed Abraham because of his belief, that is the promise that we have too. God will bless us based upon our belief, our faith. And so oftentimes we think that because we do good things, that God will bless us with good things. But the good things are simply the fruit on the tree, so to speak. But the root of the tree is faith. Without the faith, the works wouldn't be there. The faith is the seed, the root of the tree, and the different types of fruit on the tree are the many works that we perform in the name of Jesus and to the glory of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, friends, we're going to end there today. I'm so thankful that you're here with us. I trust that you're being blessed and challenged, ministered to, and encouraged in your walk with King Jesus. Now, as he wills, and until next time, friends, I'll see you on the next video.